Welcome back to Let's Deal Hand of Fate. I'm BurningDogFace, and this is it. The Last King. The King of Scales. My one true foe.
It would be so easy to create a game that merely defeats you. A game in which you stand no chance, also completely unfair. That is not how I work. I refuse to play in such a manner. Our game is fair, and you will be defeated fairly. The gods look upon you favorably.
Nice! Thank you, almighty gods. This shit again. Okay.
Claim this and claim my token.
Ah, well. After 2 days of searching, the captain finally admits defeat. I'll never likely see my wench again, he moans tearfully. Yeah, okay. Oh, Christ, I really need to get rid of that curse. Problem is, the ones that the bosses give you are always super expensive to break. The only time I've ever actually gotten rid of one is when I got the reformed Spirit of the Sea, whatever it's called, and she helpfully did that for me.
I'm sure you're grateful for that.
Nope, I'm actually kind of pissed off that it's so expensive. Pain! You know what? Let's keep going.
An expedition. Press on.
Even if I beat him this time and finish the game, I'll want to keep coming back to find out the ends of those quest lines. I can't even remember if you guys got to see Alicia in Underworld the first time. Didn't work out, so you know. Sorry, just kind of staring off into space.
I was left these simple pieces, and from them I have built a palace of memories, a convoluted maze that few will ever reach the end of. Will you be one of them?
I have no idea what this is.
A final encounter with the druids. Or is it?
Oh, this.
A challenge for you, and a token if you succeed.
You arrive at the sacred stones to find the robed druids again waiting for you in silence. For this final ritual, you must place whatever enchanted items you possess in this chest next to the stone table. Fuck. Our magics are delicate and may not be disturbed. We have brought common replacements for you to use to ward us during the ceremony. What? I wasn't given an option! You refuse? Consider how profitable our arrangement has been in the past. I offer you five times the reward we gave you last time. Place your gear into the chest and take out the old equipment. Now we may begin, the druid declares. Oh, Christ. Wordlessly, the other monks tear off their robes, revealing nothing but bones animated by dark magic. Their leader pulls back his hood to stare at you with dark, undead eyes. So they were never druids to begin with. They're not nature magicians. They're, liches. Their participation was crucial in the earlier rituals by sacrificing those creatures to the Dark One. It was crucial for this next part to succeed. But now you need only die to complete the ritual and become my unholy champion. The dealer draws you one monster card.
The King of Death in life.
That's one!
In time, all passed through my halls, but not he. Not yet.
Oh, that's not good. Somebody's unholy champion. I wonder if you refuse, if they just do it anyway and you get to keep your shit.
I was foolish to fear you.
Oh.
The cold embrace of death and the first stuttering steps of new life. You keep coming back. There is strength in that.
Let's give that another shot.
Again, the great lizard will rebuff you. We're all merely pieces upon the board. The circle repeats without end. Does the rook understand the oblivion that engulfs it when it is placed back in the box? Does the king understand that he truly rules over nothing?
I haven't heard that one before. And it still kind of irks me that the audio and the subtitles aren't synchronized. Skeleton King Shield. A shield bash can kill regular skeletons and stun other targets. Fuck yeah, I'll take that.
Really? Is that what you're going to do?
Hey, it killed me last time. I know it's good. Self-righteous. On any hit, the player inflicts 2 more damage for each blessing they possess. Including that one, presumably. Fuck. Well, I definitely want the metal.
Ascend ever deeper into the subterranean pit.
Metal is the only way to get that one hammer. I do like that you can't fail in that one. Oh. Now let's do this. Stranger takes the jar, handing over a few coins. To your surprise, he immediately opens it, but is disappointed to find nothing inside. Blast! I'll never find it, he mutters, walking away. I believe, if you succeed there, then he opens it and says, oh, this isn't what I was looking for, but there's a magic item inside. Here, you can have it. Yeah, okay, I don't even remember where the dark crystal is.
Once more, the temptation to meddle arises.
Dark Crystal Part 2.
We play for a token now.
You reach the cave described to you by Bazagra the Wizard and discover that it does contain a giant dark crystal, as he claimed. What the fuck? Unfortunately, his description of a chamber full of lava golems is also accurate. Fuck! You enter the chamber in a run, bellowing a ferocious battle cry. Well, they may kick my ass, but they'll never kick my freedom. Oh, that's not good. This is a very small arena for fighting lava golems. Regular axe, don't fail me now. AIDS. No! No way to keep focusing on a different one, just have to keep punching till they stop moving. Interrupted my animation. Oh my God. None of them have died yet! No! These assholes seem to be stun-proof, which is great. Several dicks! You better facepalm. I can't believe I won. As the last golem falls, the wizard suddenly appears. Great work, my friend. Return to this chamber in 1 month, and you shall find the crystal ready to use. This card's token is now yours. AIDS!
Bound once more. Seeking the heart of it all. Every card drawn from your thoughts and your memories. Every card tainted by your view of the world and your single-minded purpose. The same singularity of purpose that brings you here.
Tracks in town. You're traveling through a quiet hamlet. At first, its rural aspect appears quaintly serene, but as you near the central square, you realize that the lack of activity is due to disaster. A scene of great destruction reveals itself, and you wonder what army or force of nature besieged this place. You spot one villager retrieving their belongings in a pile of rubble that used to be their home. You call out to them. I was following the failure that time. The villager's head snaps around like a frightened woodland creature. Are you quite mad? Such noise will only tempt the beast to return! Can you not see that we've suffered enough? And further, quieter. Upon further quieter inquiry, the villager tells you that a ghostly pale beast smashed through town a few days before. It destroyed or devoured everything in its path before heading east out of town. May the gods have mercy on any who cross its path. You cannot tell whether this is a warning or a prayer. What?
Again, a token is at stake.
I'm pretty sure it's always four here. We can do this. I wonder if I would make the controller unusable if I tried to, grease it up a little. No! Come on, assholes! Come on, come on! Fuck yeah, Shield Bash. You honor us and the Kraken with your strength. Now that I think it might have been that I was advised to do, not counter. You honor us and the Kraken with your strength. The Elder Lizard awaits you. Bring her your rarest materials. What does that mean? This card's token is now yours. Achievement unlocked. The Elder Lizard. Trade with the Elder Lizard. Well, it doesn't say complete the dungeon, but I'm satisfied anyway. Pain?
Huh.
Oh no, this is Drax in the mud. It is easy to follow the trail of carnage from town into the woods. However, once there, it becomes much more difficult. Many animals and beasts travel here, and their tracks are crossed and confused. I don't want to fight the goddamn thing now. I have no idea. This gigantic beast leaves tracks that are easy enough to follow. AIDS! I have to go there because I don't want to take any unnecessary steps. The smell hits you like a hammer blow, twisting your stomach into knots. You follow the tracks to a lair or den of some kind. This is where it feeds. Blood stains the broken ground where it mangles its prey. You wait in the shadows, where you both hope for and dread its return. Oh, sorry. When it said you both, I thought it meant the two of you, as opposed to where you feel both hope and dread.
A choice. Select your desire.
Oh. You feel the ground tremble before any sound reaches your ears. Then you hear the forest giving way to the unimaginable force that is approaching. Moments later, the white minotaur's gargantuan form explodes into view, clenching tonight's meal in its jaws. You ready your weapon for the fight, but before you can react, a musket blast rings out from another hiding spot, narrowly missing the creature. Behind its eyes, you watch the minotaur consider whether to fight or flee. The huntsman reveals himself, and the great beast roars, then turns tail, with the huntsman in close pursuit. Oh, sorry, I thought stairs in the middle.
All sorts of terrible things live in caves. Are you sure?
Fuck no. I learned my lesson last time, so I'm going to call it here. Before we continue the tale of the Minotaur, which has consumed this level. I'm BurningDogFace, and I'll see you in the next episode of Let's Deal Hand of Fate. When I continue pursuing the Minotaur and the Huntsman who has dedicated himself to its destruction. But before then, I'll see you on a return to Shantae Risky's Revenge as I keep searching nooks and crannies for magic jam. Later!